Let's take a look at how to add and subtract positive and negative numbers. So we're going to divide the situation into two cases. The first case is when you're adding two numbers together, and the second case is when you're subtracting two numbers. So first, thinking about adding two numbers. Well, it's clear how to go forth if we're adding two positive numbers together. If somebody asks us to add, 7 added to 15, well, we know that's equal to 22. So one way to think about that the situation, as you know, is if I had $7 and I add it to $15, I have $22. Now, what if somebody asked you, instead of adding positive 7 to positive 15, what if you wanted to add, let's say we had 8, and we wanted to add that to negative 3. Now, if we think about this in the same way we just thought about 7 plus 15, that is, if we think about this in terms of money, and this was your bank statement, and your bank statement said you saw a positive 8, and then you were adding that to a negative 3, well, this would correspond to a deposit in your bank account, and this would correspond to a withdrawal because it's negative. So if you had a positive 8 in your bank account and you saw a withdrawal of 3, well, this would act against that. That is, you put $8 in, but then you withdrew 3, so you'd have a net total of 5. Okay? So that's exactly how we're going to think about adding numbers together. Okay, so we're going to break this into two situations like I mentioned, and the first situation is when you're adding two numbers together, and the second situation is where you're subtracting. So whenever we add two numbers together, two positive and or negative numbers together, or a positive and a negative, the way we do it is we think about as if we were adding two numbers in our bank account. So let's try this again. Let's go ahead and add. Let's say we wanted to add negative 3, and to that I want to add, let's go with negative 9. So first of all, I look at this problem and I notice that it's addition. So I'm adding the number negative 3 to negative 9. And I remember that whenever it's addition, we think in terms of our bank account. And if it's a withdrawal of 3 and we're adding that to a withdrawal of 9, well, now we have two withdrawals. And the total withdrawal is going to be 12, right? And so a negative added to a negative is another negative in this case. And we get negative 12. And that'll always be the case. A negative added to a negative will always be a negative, in the same way that a withdrawal, that is two withdrawals, gives a larger withdrawal, if you will. Okay, now what would happen in the case where you have subtraction? Now subtraction is going to be, we're going to also look at this and think about two situations. So first of all, you could have a number and you could be taking a number like 5, and you can, from it, you could either subtract a positive or you could subtract a negative. So for example, if I take 5 and I subtract 3, obviously I'm taking 5 and I'm subtracting a positive. But on the other hand, I could also take 5. I could also take 5 and I could subtract a negative. So 5 take away about negative 4. Okay? So we have two situations here. 5 take away a positive and 5 take away a negative. So we're going to handle this case first. That is, when you have a number and you're subtracting a negative. Now whenever that happens, we always change this to positive. So we change minus a negative to addition. So 5 minus negative 4 becomes 5 plus positive 4, which is what we were talking about in the situation above. So I've turned subtraction into addition. And you only do that when you're subtracting a negative. And we'll explain why that's the case in the next video. So 5 plus 4, I know that is equal to 9. Okay, and this technique actually works for more complicated situations as well. So for example, Let's say that I wanted to subtract 7 and I wanted to subtract -3. Well, like I said earlier, whenever you're subtracting a negative, we always change it to addition. So instead of -7 take away -3, it's going to be -7 plus +3. So here we go. We're going to change this to positive, and it becomes addition, and that becomes a +3. So now I'm in the situation above. I have a negative added to a positive. So whenever it's addition, I think about my bank account, and I say, okay, a withdrawal of -7 or a withdrawal of 7 added to it a +3, and I can see that I end up with a withdrawal of 4, or my bank account would read -4 because I had a larger withdrawal than I had a deposit. Okay, now, what happens back to the situation over here? How are we going to handle the situation when it's strictly subtraction? This, we haven't talked about this yet. Now, we know that 5 take away 3 is equal to 2, but there's another way to think about this situation. What we're going to do is we're going to think about the number line. Now, the number line is a line on which you can think all numbers live, if you will. All real numbers live, and we'll talk about that a little bit later as well. So in this case, I'm thinking about the number 5, and where would 5 live, if you will, on the number line? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so what we're going to do is we're going to say whenever it's pure subtraction, and what I mean by that is whenever you have subtraction that hasn't been converted to addition, what we're going to do is we're going to view it in the following way. 5 take away 3, we're going to start at 5, and this is going to tell us to move to the left that number of places on the number line. So 5 take away 3 says start at 5 and move to the left 3. And where do we end up? Well, we start at 5, and if we move to the left 3, it's going to be 1, 2, 3. And where I end up at is 2, and that's exactly my answer here. Now, this is going to be convenient even when the situation gets more complicated. So, for example, let's say that you wanted to subtract. Okay, and let's say we had, let's go with, how about -4 minus 2. So I look at this problem and I notice that this is -4 take away 2, and I am not subtracting a negative, right? I'm taking -4 and I'm subtracting a positive. And so the way we handle that is the way I handled the previous situation. That is, we refer to the number line. Remember, if I was subtracting a negative, that's when I would convert it to addition. But when I'm subtracting +2, I handle this using our number line example. So I'm going to draw my number line. Okay, and on the number line, I'm going to put the number -4. Now, I'm going to put -4, but I'm going to remember that when I subtract, I move to the left this many units. So here's -4, and this would be -5, and this would be -6, -7, -8, and -9. So this problem says start at -4, that's right here, and then move to the left 2. So whenever we subtract, that means move to the left that number, if that's a positive number. So -4, move to the left 2. So here's -4, move to the left 1, 2, and I end up with -6. And that's why -4 take away 2 is -6. So in the next video, what we'll do is we'll talk about why, when we had the situation earlier, for example, when we took 5 and we subtracted -3, why, when you subtract a negative, that turns into adding, in this case, +3. So 5 plus 3, thinking about my bank account again, that would be 8. Okay? So to recap what we talked about in this video, when it's addition, we think about our bank account and we add our deposits to our withdrawals. But then when it's subtraction, we have to think about two situations. Do you convert it to addition? Are you subtracting a negative? And if so, then it's addition, like we just mentioned. Or are you subtracting a positive? And if that's the case, then you refer to the number line and move to the left that number of units from where you started, which in this case was negative 4, which is why negative 4 moving to the left 2 gave us negative 6. All right, so in the next video, we'll talk about why subtracting a negative is really the same as adding the positive.